Sean hasn't done his homework yet. Grace has Sean this weekend. Seems like he can't wait to get back to his mother. I wrote a reminder note on the board in the kitchen. Time for a snack. Maybe Sean is hungry. What do you say we play together for a while?
I'd rather watch TV.
It's time for your snack. Are you hungry?
I guess, a little.
Let's see what we can find in the kitchen. Here, Sean. Here's your snack.
Thanks, Dad.
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad, let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
I think we should just get right to it. Then it's done and out of the way. Now, get your bag and get set up in the kitchen. I'll help you.
Dad, I'm finished. Can I go watch TV?
Let me have a look. Pretty good. Looks like you're done. Off you go. When the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them, they cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. The children had never been seen again. You've got a cold coming on. I'm gonna see if I can find some medicine for you. So, do you wanna talk a little?
Talk about what?
I don't know, about you, your friends. How things are going?
Nothing special.
How are things at school? Is your teacher nice?
Everything's fine, Dad.
I think there's some medicine in the bathroom cabinet. Sean's sneezing. I think he's catching a cold. Thank you. It's dinner time. I'd better make something for Sean. Here, take this. It'll make you feel better.
Thanks, Dad.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
Oh, yeah. I'm really hungry.
Okay, I'll go see what I can find. I'll call you when it's ready. You can come now, Sean. Your meal is ready.
I'm coming!
Stop messing around or I'll never be able to film you.
What do you want me to do?
I don't know. Oh, yeah, Jason, tell me what you want to be when you grow up.
I don't know. Maybe a fireman or an astronaut. Oh, wait, I know. I'll be a dinosaur hunter.
I'll make video games.
And here's the most beautiful mother in the whole wide world.
Well, don't film me. You know I don't like it.
Hey, Dad, film me. I'll show you how fast I can run.
Yeah, me too, Dad. I can run really fast, too.
This film, I just can't stop watching it. I'm sorry, Jason. I'm so sorry. Nothing but dust and memories. Stuff that takes me back to the past. It's Sean's bedtime. Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
Now, that's not very reasonable, is it? You have school tomorrow. You have to get some sleep.
All right, I'm going. Are you coming with me?
Go brush your teeth and put on your pajamas. I'll come up. Good night, Sean.
My teddy! I haven't got my teddy, Dad!
You must have left it somewhere in the house. Do you have any idea where it could be?
No, Dad. Please, I can't sleep without him.
All right, I'll have a look around and see if I can find it, okay?
Thanks, Dad.
Good night, Sean.
Night. Dad?
Yeah?
Why do you look so sad?
I think I just need some time to get back to the way things were.
You know, Dad, what happened to Jason wasn't your fault.
Good night, Sean. I don't feel tired. I'll go downstairs, grab some fresh air.
Thank you. Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope, can't say it does.
Been looking for weeks. Hope I hit pay dirt this time. Guess I better take the stairs.
Oh, that Lauren Winter. Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Lauren Winter?
Sorry, I only see clients by appointment.
Wait.
It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings, it's over, okay? You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ugh, shit, a cop. I should have known. What do you want, a freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
I already told the police all I know and I have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
There'll be other victims if we don't stop the killer. You have got to help me, Lauren. You may know something that can aid the investigation.
Help you? There's nothing you can do! My son's dead, do you hear me? He's dead!
I understand, Lauren. I know what you're going through.
Oh yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's body on a deserted wasteland. But you're right! Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
What do you want to know?
Did you suspect anyone after he disappeared?
I meet a lot of pretty shady characters in my line of work. Sure, I thought of it at first. But it didn't seem to make any sense. I don't believe any of my clients could have done that to my Johnny and all those other kids.
Tell me about Johnny. What kind of kid was he?
Johnny was really a good boy. Sometimes he fought with other kids who called me a, you know. In his own way, I think he understood what was going on. You want one?
No thanks, I quit.
That's brave.
Did Johnny live with you?
Yes. Of course, I made sure he never met any of my clients. I wanted to stop, you know. But we needed the money. I was trying to earn enough to get us out of here.
Tell me about Johnny's father.
A loser without a job who liked to beat me after a few drinks. He left the day Johnny disappeared. I ain't seen him since. Coward. Good thing he left. Time's up, Mr. Shelby. I hope you got what you wanted. Now get out of here.
I didn't learn squat. Well, it's worth a try. I'll leave my card on the kitchen table. You never know.
No point in pushing it. She's not going to tell me anymore.
Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call.
I gotta get out of here.
Asthma.
And it's not gonna get any better this friggin' weather.
What do you want, asshole?
Lauren, is everything all right?
She's just swell. Now beat it, loser!
Tough guy, huh? Looks like he needs a little lesson from the school of hard knocks.
You again?
Are you all right?
Better than him, I guess. Who is he?
An ex-client who thinks he owns me. He was getting violent, and I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
Well, you should be careful. He'll probably be back. Sorry about the mess.
Mr. Shelby?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Oh. Oh, God.